Hello everyone and welcome to a service for Ash Wednesday, and we begin with a prayer. God of our days and years, we set this time apart for you. Form us in the likeness of Christ so that our lives may glorify you. Amen. Ash Wednesday marks the beginning of the season of Lent. Today we take the opportunity to think about the things we've done wrong so that we can say sorry and ask for God's forgiveness. Traditionally, we would receive the mark of the cross in ash on our foreheads, a sign of our penitence and a sign of the forgiveness we've received. We then go into the season of Lent leading up to Easter with the intention of drawing closer to God and asking him to strengthen us in our faith, to remind us that we come to God just as we are. Let's listen to and sing along with the hymn, Just As I Am.
Just as I am.
Lent is the season of the Christian year that begins on Ash Wednesday. It lasts for 40 days and leads up to the joyful celebration of Easter. It is for Christians a time of fasting, prayer, penance, and charity. On Ash Wednesday, Christians gather to celebrate the Eucharist and to have a cross of ash traced on their foreheads. This powerful symbol reminds us that we don't live forever, and that we need to put right the things in our lives that separate us from one another and from God. As the priest traces the cross, the words, "Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return," are said. By receiving the cross of ash, we acknowledge our human frailty and our dependence upon God's healing grace. The 40 days of Lent are a time for growth, and for drawing closer to Jesus on our Christian pilgrimage, for reflecting on what really matters in our lives, and for turning back to God in repentance. This prayerful time of fasting and repentance enables us to grow more fully into the people God made and calls us to be, transforming us into the likeness of Jesus Christ, whose death and resurrection we will celebrate in Holy Week and at Easter.
Be careful not to practice your righteousness in front of others to be seen by them. If you do, you will have no reward from your Father in heaven. So when you give to the needy, do not announce it with trumpets, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and on the streets, to be honored by others. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. And when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father who is unseen. Then your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. When you fast, do not look somber as the hypocrites do, for they disfigure their faces to show others they are fasting. Truly I tell you, they have received their reward in full. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that it will not be obvious to others that you're fasting, but only to your Father who is unseen. And your Father, who sees what is done in secret, will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
Have you ever wondered why the church invented the season of Lent? Was it just to spoil everyone's fun? Or going back further, why do you think Jesus was sent into the desert to spend 40 days alone, fasting? Was it some sort of punishment? It might seem like punishment, but we know that it was exactly the opposite. The period in the desert was meant to strengthen Jesus and to remind him that whatever he was going to face in his ministry, God the Father and God the Holy Spirit would be with him. We know this because Jesus went into the desert immediately after his baptism, immediately after hearing these words of affirmation from his Father. "This is my Son, whom I love. With him, I am well pleased." We know this because we're told that Jesus was led into the desert by the Spirit, the same Spirit that had just descended on him like a dove. We know this because Mark tells us that Jesus was attended by angels while he was in the desert. Going back to the early church and the invention of the season of Lent, I believe that this too was not about devising some sort of punishment for Christian believers, but exactly the opposite. It was meant to provide a means of strengthening our faith, a means of drawing closer to God, a means of becoming refocused along which Jesus calls us to follow him. And we can be really confident that this period is never about being punished, because it begins traditionally with a very visible symbol of the forgiveness that we've received. And if we've been forgiven, we don't need to be punished. On Ash Wednesday, we are invited to make our confession, to say sorry for the things we've done and for the right things we've failed to do. Then we receive the sign of that forgiveness in the cross marked on our foreheads with ash, accompanied by these words: The Lord enrich you with his grace and nourish you with his blessing. The Lord defend you in trouble and keep you from all evil. The Lord accept your prayers and absolve you from all your offences for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. We are sent out into the season of Lent with those words, words of encouragement and blessing. And the things that we do in Lent are supposed to help us on the next stage of our faith journey, whether that's fasting or giving up things we enjoy, like chocolate or alcohol, or carrying out extra acts of kindness, or making extra donations to charities, or spending more time in prayer or Bible study. What we each have to decide is which of those things is going to help us to draw closer to God. Which of those things will make our time in the desert more life-enhancing? Lent is a season which we share together across the church in many different traditions and denominations. But at the same time, it's a very personal time as we try to deepen our relationship with God. In the passage from Matthew's Gospel, Jesus is criticising those people who use the disciplines of prayer, giving and fasting to try to prove to others how good they are in their religious practices. Elsewhere in the Bible, we read about how Jesus encourages us to pray together and to learn together. At the same time, he emphasises the importance of our own very personal relationship with him. So in Lent, we do both. We meet together to encourage each other so that our individual, our personal meetings with Jesus can be deeper and more life-giving. Rather than thinking of Lent as a difficult time to be endured, let's think of it as an invitation to spend more time with Jesus, focused on what he wants to share with us. Horatius Bonner wrote a well-known hymn, "I Heard the Voice of Jesus." I think the words of the hymn are a good reminder of what Lent can be for us. As we listen to Jesus, we hear him say words of invitation. "Come unto me and rest. Drink the living water. Look on me, this dark world's light." So this Lent, let's come to Jesus and listen well so that we can hear what he's saying to us. Let's come to Jesus and receive both the rest and the refreshment which he offers. Let's come to Jesus and receive his light so that we can walk in the light of life always. Let's now have a time of prayer, bringing our prayers of penitence to God and bringing before him our prayers for the world and for ourselves. So let's pray. Holy God, our lives are laid open before you. Rescue us from the chaos of sin, and through the death of your Son, bring us healing and make us whole. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us now call to mind our sin and the infinite mercy of God. God the Father, have mercy upon us. God the Son, have mercy upon us. God the Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. Trinity of love, have mercy upon us. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart, mind, and strength. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven. Lord, have mercy. We have been deaf to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. We confess to you, Lord, all our past unfaithfulness, the pride, hypocrisy, and impatience of our lives. Lord, have mercy. Our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people. Lord, have mercy. Our anger at our own frustration, and our envy of those more fortunate than ourselves. Lord, have mercy. Our intemperate love of worldly goods and comforts, and our dishonesty in daily life and work. Lord, have mercy. Our negligence in prayer and worship, and our failure to commend the faith that is in us. Lord, have mercy. Accept our repentance, Lord, for the wrongs we have done, for our blindness to human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty. Accept our repentance, Lord. For all false judgments or uncharitable thoughts towards our neighbours, and for our prejudice and contempt toward those who differ from us. Accept our repentance, Lord. For our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who come after us, accept our repentance, Lord. Restore us, good Lord, and let your anger depart from us. Favourably hear us, for your mercy is great. Accomplish in us the work of your salvation, that we may show your glory in the world. By the cross and passion of your Son, our Lord, bring us with all your saints to the joy of his resurrection. We keep silence for a moment. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Obviously, I cannot make the sign of the cross on your forehead with ash today, but I wondered if we could actually make the sign of the cross on ourselves, and I suggest on the palm of our hands, because we can see the shape that we're making. So we make the sign of the cross on the palm of our hand as a reminder of the forgiveness that we've received from God. And as you hold that shape of the cross in your mind, please receive this absolution and blessing. The Lord enrich you with his grace and nourish you with his blessing. The Lord defend you in trouble and keep you from all evil. The Lord accept your prayers and absolve you from all your offences for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. And now let us pray for a moment in silence for our own needs, and for the needs of others. Heavenly Father, we bring our prayers to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's join together in prayer now, in the words of the diocesan prayer. Living God, Jesus calls his followers to seek first your kingdom. Renew us as we make your love known. Release us to share freely together in mission. And rejuvenate us to be fruitful in your service. Give us courage, wisdom, and compassion that, strengthened with the grace of the Holy Spirit, we may, as the Diocese of Sheffield, both flourish and grow. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross, and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Let's finish our time together by listening to or joining in with the hymn, I Heard the Voice of Jesus.